At the Kaz men, but Tynecastle, never an easy place to come to. Although Rangers' recent record here, not too bad. They've won on their last three visits. At this, another game, Rangers simply have to win. Hearts, meanwhile, are faster with the arrival of Craig Levein, and some of these players are playing today to stay at the club. The new manager has said he'll cut back on staff. Levein might learn more in the next 90 minutes than he did in 3 years at Cowden Beath. Attacking look about Hearts this afternoon. Wanzo, Gordon Jury and Andy Kirk up front. Here's Colin Cameron. And Jury going against his former side. Cameron, first efforts. Stefan Klos. Here's a man who does seem destined to go places, Colin Cameron. Claudio Reyna back in the side after an absence. He's played the last few games and been very effective. Great ball from Ferguson. Cross in for Miller, but that's Gordon Petric with the sliding tackle. Good defending by Petric. Alberts. Crossover. Amoruso with the chance. Almost a free header. And he really might have done better with that one. Disappointed with himself. Made by Reina. As far as Fulton, and that's nicely played by Hearts. Wanzo with a chance here for Hearts. It's well blocked by Scott Wilson. That's good defending by the Rangers man, but Wanzo saw space in front of him. The goalkeeper and the goal were exposed, but good defending by Scott Wilson. Here, Amoruso. That's a great ball for Ferguson. What a great run from Ferguson. He's brought down by Petric. Petric can't believe it, the penalty has been given. The Hearts fans can't believe it either, but I think you'll find he really doesn't have a case here. The ball played by Ferguson, he's then brought down by the defender, and that will be a penalty for Rangers. First goal, always vital in a game such as this. Can Alberts do it for Rangers? Well, there's no doubt about that one. He wasn't going to place it, he wasn't going to miss it. Into the corner. Rangers, one up. Reina has some space, some time here. It's a nice 1-2, good shot from Reina. A nice move again from Rangers. Always rising over the bar, but Reina saw the opportunity. Came forward and played the 1-2 nicely. Outside the foot, give and go as they call it. Presley picks up the far side, but De Boer has the strength to hold him off. And he can't quite take the ball with him, Ronald De Boer. Cameron picks up nicely for Hearts. And there's promise here in this move. Three players down that far side. Ball comes in. It's a chance for Judy, and a great save by Klos. The header directed to the bottom corner. A German in the right place at the right time. Fulton. As he punches out only as far as a Hearts man, Judy again. Klos at the second attempt. He's earned his money already. It was Scott Severin with the first chance. As the ball came over, it fell for Severin. The shot came off De Boer, and then Judy. Well, the Hearts fans must have thought that was going in, but Klos had other ideas. For a head, that head could be Jury. Plays it forward, a chance now for Hearts. Once again, Stefan Klos to the rescue for Rangers. And really, Hearts should have been level. And there's a forward looking for Newman. Presley is there for Hearts. Now De Boer, plenty of targets to pick out inside the penalty area. But the flick on at front post and didn't materialise. This didn't happen for Rangers. And a different kind of set piece now from the throw. Kick. And it's De Boer once again. See if he can do better this time. Post, Amoruso was there, but crowded out by two defenders. As the half-time whistle goes, it's been a reasonably good first half for Rangers. They took an early lead from the penalty spot through George Alberts. Gordon Petrick's tackle on Barry Ferguson. It was all about the quality of the pass. Ferguson made a great run. And George Alberts made no mistake from the spot. So at half-time, the score at Tynecastle is Hearts 0, Rangers 1.
Sponsored by Skelly's Motherwell, the trade-in specialist.
At Scottish Power, we've low prices always.
Save an amazing £100 when you buy this Sony TV and video package. Knockout value from Scottish Power.
Service and MOT test for only £78. Call Arnold.
We were going to do a taste test with another leading stimulation drink, but three flavours against one. It just ain't fair, is it?
Intelligent Finance. Call 0845 600 4343 or visit if.com.
Brighter prices, brighter Christmas.
I can't believe I'm doing this again. I must be totally mad.
God, where's your Christmas spirit, boy? Lovely.
Get off me, Tim. Stop it. You're rude, you are.
At the Co-op this Christmas, you'll find everything you need to make this party season your best ever.
Mum! Uncle Bernie's at the door.
Oh, well, hello.
Colin, where's your Christmas spirit? Merry Christmas, Bernie, love.
Co-op, there for you.
Ho, ho, ho.
Sweetheart, could you get those special chocolates?
Of course. Now, who's for coffee?
Darling, weren't you getting a Ferrero Rocher?
Of course I was. Cognac.
And the chocolates?
Well, Gina, I think I've got to buy... I'll go and get them.
You and Rolf.
There's Sorry.
Give Ferrero Rocher.
Sponsored by Skelly's Motherwell, the trade-in specialist.
We'll soon find out what difference Craig Levine can make to Hearts after his first half-time team talk. Rangers one up, of course, but Hearts making the best of that first half in terms of chances. 45 minutes left for Levine to take something from his first game in charge. 45 minutes left for Rangers to add to that one goal from the penalty spot by George Alberts. Rangers pick up possession. Ronald de Boer took his player out of the game quite nicely. Nice turn of pace. 1-2 with Albert Stabur. And a chance for Flo with the shot. And deflection, taking it over the bar. And signs there's more to come from Tori Andre Flo. He can't possibly be properly match fit. Reasonable effort. The deflection. He's always taking it well over the bar. This is Kirk. He's got Juanjo with him. Good shot from Kirk. Oh, good effort. Whistled over the crossbar. He had the option of Juanjo with him. He did take it. He used the space he had to fire in the shot. Only one thought in his mind as he picked this ball up at halfway. There's Juanjo in the middle, but Kirk always looking to test Klos. And Rangers come forward again. That's a great ball for Kenny Miller. It's a great ball. Miller has space and he's got time and he's got flow. And that was a great chance for Rangers. And Tori Andre Flo will feel he should have made it a goal again. The flag stayed down. Hearts were looking for offside. Kenny Miller on the break. Flo, you can see inside. And Miller had time to look up and to pick him out. And Flo reached the ball before the keeper. Inches wide. Long ball for Flo. Flo trying to find Miller. In fact, Ferguson, he's done well. Petric shepherding at the corner flag. Free kick, once again the yellow card. Reina bringing Murray down. The ball going at Hart's way on the far side, but trouble here. And a second yellow and a red for Claudio Reina. He really should have known better, he had just been booked. It was a silly challenge. I think he's maybe claiming the Hearts man made the most of it. Stuart Dougal with no option here. Well, you see the arm round Kirk and there really is no option for the referee. Reina had just been booked and this was stupidity. Kirk was through, he was past him. You can see the arm up. It's a second yellow and a red for Claudio Reina. Chance now for Hearts to come forward with Nielsen. Was he fouled? Yes, he was. And once again, the book is out. Arthur Newman will receive the yellow card. Yes, he does. Dougal saying, I'm in charge, don't argue. And certainly has shown today he's not a man to be argued with. It's a busy time for the fourth official as well. Nine players booked and one sent off. And there's more trouble here. It's not finished yet because Newman continued his arguments. And again, stupidity will cost Rangers a man because it's a second red card for a Rangers player here. Arthur Newman simply cannot believe it. But once again, within seconds of receiving a yellow card, the red is out, Newman is off, and Rangers are down to nine men. Free kick for Hearts. Ferguson, push in the back. Quickly taken. Chance for Nielsen to put it into the area, plays it back. Cross comes in, the chance for Hearts. That was always the goalkeeper's ball. Kirk with a good header. You can see Klos always behind it. But an instance there that Hearts could find space now with Rangers depleted. And it's a good save again by Klos. Hearts with men in space. They have an overlap on both sides. Here's Milne. Kenny Milne, the substitute. That's a great ball too. There's a real chance now for Hearts. In the back, a good save again by Klos. Like to pass inside the penalty area. Whenever he gets a chance, he goes for a shot. You can see he's at full stretch, and instead of cutting across, he's gone for the near post. Cameron And there's plenty of room again on the flanks. Lack of concentration from Presley. Alberts, a good run. He's on the left foot. He's looking for the chance to shoot Alberts. This could wrap it up for Rangers. Oh, it's been a long run. Tired legs and a tired looking shot at the end. He maybe ran out of angles here. It was a good run by Alberts. He really had only one option. Nobody up with him. Hearts player to ground. Alberts with a chance to shoot. He expected perhaps the ball to go across the keeper. That one into the side net. Ball across, and a chance now for Hearts. Again, it's Klos to the rescue. How on earth did Hearts not score there? And if that is an indication, Rangers will take the 3 points for this game, because Stefan Klos just will not be beaten this afternoon. Across, the shot from Judy Kirk with the header, and once again, Stefan, the barrier between Hearts and the Rangers' goal. And Judy wants it. Nielsen. Now Fulton. Plays it wide. Is there a chance for a shot? Yes, there is a chance for a shot, but well wide of the goals. Klos, you can see from his reaction, Grant Murray's effort was never going to cause him any problem. They've had possession, they've had space, as you would expect against nine men, but they haven't been able to conjure a goal. That's mostly thanks to Stefan Klos, who has produced a mighty performance here at Tynecastle. Stefan Klos has been the difference between these sides. He's been congratulated by his own players, Alberts, and that is a hug that says thank you very much, because Klos made several outstanding saves from Judy in the first half, from Kirk, and then from Kirk again in the second. But the only goal came from the penalty spot. Gordon Petric fouled Barry Ferguson. George Alberts made no mistake, and that man there, Stefan Klos, has helped to make a final score here at Tynecastle of Hearts 0, Rangers 1.
3 points there, a very, very important one for Rangers. It was a tough one for you.
Very tough, very difficult. Difficult. I think the only good thing today was that we got the 3 points with a little bit of luck. So that's right.
And a stunning performance from Stefan Klos, your goalkeeper.
Yeah, well, I think if they sent two players off and then with eight field players, even 11 against 11, it's a little difficult here. But we worked very, very hard to get a result, and with a little bit of luck, with a little bit good defending, but also with some good saves from Klos, yeah, he saved the game for us.
I felt we created chances today, the willingness of the strikers to put himself in positions where if you miss you get criticised, if you score you're zero. They went in there time and time again, and if it hadn't been for the goalkeeper on his form today, then we would have got at least a point today, I think.
What did you make of the two orderings off?
Yeah, I don't think it's a good idea to say something about it, because everybody's watching me, and you're not allowed here in this country to say something about it, because otherwise they punish me, and I don't want it.
Yeah, it was nice to be back, and I was thrilled with the reception that I received from the supporters. And Peter and I set out today to have a go, you know, to try and lift the crowd and let them see that we're trying, you know, we're trying to score goals, we're trying to beat Rangers at home.